And we are here at PAX, and I am joined by David Grossman from Telltale Games. David, how you doing, sir?
I'm doing very well. I love PAX.
I love PAX, too. We were just talking about that. This used to be the most common conversation is you talk to people from the industry, and it's like, wow, PAX is really awesome. This is just a fun event. There's so much about it that's just... It's so much more relaxed, and since it's, you know, so much more consumer driven, it's not like a regular press event. It's not, everyone's not going nuts crazy all the time, and I think that's probably one of my favorite things about it. What is it that you get the most out of PAX?
I like the people here. The crowd is really good. It's not crazy hardcore people, but it's sort of devoted hardcore people who are kind of friendly and into a lot of different kinds of games. They just sort of love the medium, it seems like, rather than any particular entry in the medium. We, Telltale, we kind of arm wrestle a little bit over who gets to go to PAX.
Well, I would say, this is your show. I think you definitely get to make the call that you come, I'm sure.
You'd be surprised.
Well, I'm glad that you're here, sir. I'm glad that Telltale's here. It's been, it seems like, a really great year. 2009 for Telltale has been pretty phenomenal. What is it that you guys are here showing specifically right now?
We've actually got, we're highlighting three series. We've got the Tales of Monkey Island series that's currently running. We're getting ready to release the third episode later this month. We've also got two seasons of Sam & Max that are the second one is getting ready to come out on Xbox Live Arcade. And also we've got our Strong Bad series, which we did for WiiWare. So it's a particularly good one for PAX. The Brothers Chaps seem to be popular here.
Well, I can imagine. This seems like definitely right in their wheelhouse.
Definitely.
See a lot of Homestar Runner shirts around.
Definitely.
So, okay, let's take this reverse order. So for Strong Bad, you guys have wrapped the season on that?
We have indeed wrapped the season, yes. And that's now, it's collected on a DVD that you can get for the PC, and it's available on WiiWare.
Are you guys looking to bring that to other platforms as well, or?
Time will tell.
Fair enough, sir. And then we've got two seasons of Sam & Max in the can. Second season's coming to Xbox Live Arcade. That's going to be similar to the first season, where it'll just be kind of a single package there?
Right. It'll be it'll be one great big download with all five episodes that you'll get there, similar to the collected season on DVD that we sell for PC players. Also in the Sam & Max arena, I will say that we're working on design for another season.
Fantastic. I know, like, right after the second season ended that I was very eager to see another season, but you guys instead decided to go with Tales of Monkey Island, which, you know what? I love me some Sam & Max, but I cannot complain about the return of Monkey Island.
I hope that was okay for you, because, we had been talking like we were going to do another season of Sam & Max right away, and we were a little worried, oh, people might not like it that we're not jumping right back into that, but we thought, Monkey Island would be a good substitute.
Absolutely. I think it's been really exciting just to see... that you guys were able to do this, and that you're coming back into the fold, like Telltale's history, with the Monkey Island series and with LucasArts is really interesting and kind of circuitous. The fact that it has come back around, and a lot of these key guys that are at Telltale now that had worked at LucasArts in the past are getting to make another Monkey Island game. Does it feel kind of like a homecoming with that stuff?
With all of the intended kind of nerve-wrackiness of a homecoming, too. Like, do I look as good as the other guys? And, is anybody any secret hatreds going to come to the fore or anything? I actually was most worried just about sort of coming back to the series after kind of a long hiatus during which fans had opportunity to kind of build up the nostalgic expectations of the series.
Sure.
So we really had to kind of think hard about what is important to Monkey Island, and what do we really love about the characters, and kind of focus on that core to get it right.
And it seems like the response has been super positive. Like, it seems like this has been one of the most popular things that that Telltale's done so far.
Yeah. People really like it, and we're getting a lot of positive feedback from the fans, so we're happy.
And is LucasArts happy at this point?
Seem to be.
Excellent. That's good. Because I'll tell you, some episodic Maniac Mansion stuff, if that could happen in the future. I'm sure no one else has mentioned that to you, but just thought I'd throw that out there.
No one ever mentions that.
Now, you've got two episodes that have already come out, and I've noticed a theme of Guybrush, his hand being in various states of distress over the course of the series. Is this something that that we can expect to see as kind of a running gag throughout the rest of Tales?
Well, I don't know about a running gag. There's certainly the hand does kind of figure in a bit, as does now the hook. I hope I'm not spoiling anything for.
That's like the first 5 minutes of episode two. I think we're clear.
Episode two is now out. So if you haven't played it already, then you deserve to be spoiled on the fact that Guybrush's hand gets cut off in the first couple minutes.
So I understand that. So Ron Gilbert, he's did the big keynote here. I understand that as the creator of Monkey Island, that you guys touched base with him on kind of this reemergence of the Monkey Island series. How did that go?
Really well, yeah. You know, I mean, we have a lot of the kind of original creative staff at Telltale now, but when I think Monkey Island, I think of that as kind of Ron's thing, and I know it's very near and dear to his heart, so I called him up and I said, hey, we're about to do this Monkey Island series. Do you want to tell me anything? And he said, yeah, could I just, come down and brainstorm with you guys for a few days, maybe a week or so? And so he came down and we talked over the season plan, where we wanted to go with the story arc and what should we do with the characters. And we even brainstormed some puzzles and stuff for them. It was really, it was fun. We're all concerned.
You can't really ask for much more than, the blessings and some involvement from the guy who came up with the series in the first place.
No, I really couldn't ask for more than that, actually.
So yeah, 2009, just, for you guys, it has been, like I said before, a pretty exciting, terrific year. But for adventure games in general, it's kind of baffling to think that it's 2009 and adventure games are kind of a big deal. And it seems like you guys have been really instrumental in this.
Yeah, well, I like to think so. I've always been excited about that as a form, both as a gaming form and as a storytelling form. And I think, with it, some things have changed in the industry to kind of make it possible to bring them back again. There's downloadable channels are making it easier to reach the audience, and the emergence of the casual games space is making that easier. And also just our episodic approach, I think, is adding something interesting for people.
And I think you guys are one of the few developers out there that have actually done episodic content episodically. You've actually had a schedule and then hit those dates, and people have been able to rely on that. It seems like that's kind of been the key in making episodic stuff really work. How much of a challenge has that been, just like maintaining that schedule?
Oh, that's the biggest challenge we have is keeping up with the schedule and making sure everything comes out on time. And we have to interleave the productions kind of like shingles, where several of them are in different stages all at the same time. And it's crazy to keep track of, but at the same time, we think it's really important to get it right. Because otherwise your whole episodic model falls apart. I mean, imagine you're watching your favorite TV show and you get to the end and it says, well, we're making the other one of these days. The next episode, maybe wait a year, maybe 6 months. We don't know. So you got to be able to say, yeah, next month we'll have another one for you. And
cough, Valve, cough.
I love Valve, but not for that.
I think they did themselves a disservice in calling it an episode, but great content nonetheless.
Yeah, I mean, Valve is different. They're just, this is a different ball game. They make terrific games, and they can take as long as they want to make them, and people will still be paying attention because they're Valve. So why even worry? They don't need to worry about that.
They definitely have that luxury. Now, speaking maybe a little more broadly, Telltale definitely, aside from them being adventure games, a lot of humor. Like, that's very much been the crux of all the games, the Sam and Max and, Wallace and Gromit and Strong Bad and Monkey Island. What do you think is kind of the key to doing humor in games well? Because it seems like a lot of people try it, but very few are able to pull it off. And it seems like it's something that Telltale has a specific knack for.
Wow, it's never really seemed all that hard to me personally. And that might just be an approach. I think drama is harder than comedy, but probably the number one thing to do is to hire good comedians to do your writing for you. It does help if you're doing the kind of game that has a lot of writing in it, which ours do. It's a little trickier in other kinds of genres, but still, you can make the details funny. Like Plants vs. Zombies is a great example of a game that doesn't really have much writing per se, but the little plants and the goofy looking zombies and the noises that they make when you put them all together.
Good stuff.
That's hilarious.
So we're here at PAX. Is there any? I know you're probably going to be chained to the Telltale booth for the duration of the show, but is there anything here in particular that you're hoping to be able to break away and go see or experience?
I always like to go check out the indie games, actually. There's a little group of them somewhere over there, maybe 10 or so. They're usually just sort of the most interesting and innovative stuff to look at, so I like that.
It definitely seems like, you know, what PAX is all about is the little guys.
Yeah, inventive spirit. Yeah.
So beyond a kind of ramping up and preparing for a Sam Max Season 3, anything else going on in the world of Telltale you want to talk about?
No. Cannot talk about anything.
Fair enough. I've got you too far away from PR people, I know.
Send the monkeys to my house. I'm very closely watched.
All right, so one last question, David. Do you know what the secret of Monkey Island is?
I'm not telling.
Oh. Well, David, thank you so much for your time. Appreciate it.